Please be upstanding in honor of the bride.
We don't know what tomorrow holds, but we hold who holds tomorrow. Knowing this will leave above the world and all its sorrows. I have prayed for all my life that we would be together. Serving Him together seems so right. Oh, oh yes, it's true.
Gathered here today in the presence of God and these witnesses to unite Jabez and Gazel in holy matrimony. Who gives this woman to be wedded to this man?
I do.
Family and friends, thank you for honoring our couple with your presence today. This ceremony is a declaration of their love one for another and a recognition that this is God's will for their lives from today and into the future. God, who instituted marriage, sees marriage as a sacred vow to picture Christ and his bride, the church. This is indeed a joyous occasion as they honor the Lord and his plan for their lives. Thank you for joining them on this special day. Let's pray together. Father, thank you for this wonderful occasion. Today, we will witness the commitment of Jabez and Gazel before you and these witnesses to a life of marriage. We ask for your blessing on this time, but more importantly, a greater blessing upon their marriage from this day forward. May their hearts be joined in their love for you, and may their life glorify you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated.
I'll just read a quick reading from 1 Corinthians 13, verses 1 to 10. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, I am become as sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and I give my body to be burned, and have not charity, it profiteth me nothing. Charity suffereth long and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up. Doth not behave itself unseemly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil. Rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoiceth in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away.
Well, friends, today is our wedding day, but today is also Remembrance Day. And upon the request from the couple, we would like to observe the minute silence because it is 11 o'clock. Thank you. Well, today was many firsts. That was the first time I'd seen a bride sing to her groom walking down the aisle. I don't think there was a dry eye in the room. And first time I've observed a minute silence during our wedding. Jabez and Gazel, today's the day you've been waiting for. I'm sure you've imagined what this moment might feel like. Perhaps you've even rehearsed it over and over in your mind. Yet here you are. A lifetime of waiting comes together for this day. Gazel, I'm sure that you've had times in your life where you've wondered if this day would come, if there was a man God had for you. You started to think about your wedding dress and what it will look like and what your husband will look like. And I'm sure you're not disappointed with your dress. No, and Jabez also looks very much the part. And Jabez, now that you're here, you can't help but feel and see that Gazel is more beautiful than you could have ever imagined. And how glad you are that she said yes to you. I still remember the day you told me that you liked Gazel and had asked her out. You recalled all that happened for you to meet and then become friends, and then that great realization that she was the one God had prepared for you. I've watched both of you as you've grown in your commitment to one another. And it's been a blessing to see both of you grow further in your faithfulness to the Lord. You've served Him together, and you've been a real blessing to many already. I believe that God has been guiding you forward to His plan, to this day, and to His plan unfolding in your life. And He's been the one that has orchestrated your meeting, and in the end, your commitment to each other, to this very sacred union of marriage. Marriage really has no secret recipe. It's been given plainly in the Word of God. And today marks the beginning of a lifetime of selflessness and love. And our chapter today summarizes what that's all about in the word charity. Yet, what charity does is allows you to thrive in the union God has given for this day. In Colossians 3:14, the Bible says, "And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness." Although the institution of marriage is being redefined by the world around us, God has always viewed it as a holy, binding covenant that you both make to one another in His sight. Marriage was designed by your Heavenly Father and instituted in the Garden of Eden between the first man and woman. God established the structure of marriage when He said, "Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." When a man and a woman consent to marriage, they are put together not just in the marriage ceremony, but by God Himself. Again, the Bible tells us, "Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder." It is God who put you together. And He said, "You are not to separate or divide from each other. Your partnership is one forged in complements by God's design." Your marriage is meant to be a wonderful living picture of the relationship you have with the Lord Jesus Christ. And that can only happen in your lives together if you have both been born again. Jabez and Gazel, there was a time in your lives that you put your faith and trust in the shed blood of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sin. You both realized that you were sinners in the sight of God and had broken the laws of God, and in a moment came to believe in Him for your salvation. And as the Bible said, you were saved by grace through faith. It's the gift of God. So you stand here today, having trusted Jesus Christ as your Savior, and that salvation is going to be the basis of your new life together as husband and wife. Jabez, there will be many things that compete for your attention and heart, an occupation, a hobby, or even yourself. But you're commanded by God who said, "Husbands, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave Himself for it." Your love for Gazel must be far above the other things in life. Your first concern for her must be her spiritual walk, her love for her Savior. Your desire for her must be that she is to be holy and without blemish in her relationship with Jesus Christ. You are commanded to love her as you love your own body, to nourish and cherish her in kindness, compassion, and affection. You're told to dwell with her according to knowledge, to truly know and understand who she is, and adjust your own life and lifestyle to accommodate her. You're commanded to give honor unto your wife, to treat her as a treasure, something of high value, one whose price is far above rubies. And so I charge you on this day to perform the duty required of you by God. In order for you to fulfill your vow to Gazel today, you must be selfless, stripped of personal ambition and fully dependent upon your God. You must make your own walk with God the highest priority in your life, and you must love Him supremely above all else. When a man fails to walk with God, a man falters in his marriage. Gazel, today is also a wonderful change in your life as you promise your life to this man. From today forward, your life will be centered around Jabez. This means that you must submit yourself to the authority of your husband. The Bible tells you as a wife, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. You are now to place His desires above your own. And God said of the first man that it was good, not good, that the man should be alone. So He created Eve, a fitting and suitable helper for him. In the same way, you are now to help Jabez. Your life must be given to support, help, and encourage your husband. He needs your help to complement the unfinished parts of his life. You are now entering into a lifetime together of joy, of labor, difficult times, and wonderful times. And your husband will need you to help him along that journey. Your daily walk with Jesus Christ is the only way for you to succeed as the wife God intends you to be. Gazel, you must grow in grace. You must walk in love. You must die daily to yourself, and you must be in subjection to your God and husband every day. I charge you on this day that you submit yourself to the command of God for you as a wife, and learn by a lifetime of experience the joy that can be yours as you follow the plan of God for a happy marriage. Jabez and Gazel, Although this is a solemn and serious occasion, it is a blessed and happy time and a time of rejoicing. Your partnership will flourish as you both walk with God and submit to His plan as husband and wife. I believe yours will be a partnership that will not just be one of wonderful memory, but one that will change others as well. And as your pastor, I stand ready to help and assist in any way you might need in the coming days. And as a church, we commit to being a support and encouragement along the road. May God bless you both.
Is this on?
Dear Gazel, I wish I could say that I haven't been nervous about getting married. I wish I could say that I've been as carefree about this day as I normally am. But that just wouldn't be true. The truth is, I've been terrified about this day, more than any other day. About the day when God Himself, looking down from heaven, would hold me responsible for you. About the day when I would be commanded by God to love you even as He loved the church, and giving Himself for it. I wish I could say such words to you of love without hesitation, but there has been a lot of hesitation in my heart. For the longest time, I thought I'd never get married, because the risk was too high, or because I wasn't good enough. And then God showed me you. He showed me a woman who cared beyond caring, who loved beyond duty, beyond reason, beyond hope, beyond all I've ever witnessed in a woman. You are a help beyond a helpmeet. For the first time, I'm not afraid to fully trust another. You have been to me as medicine for my soul. You are God's gift to me. Christ has called me to be your husband. And if there were any part of that calling I was unwilling to do, I would not marry. So as Christ has instructed me, I will strive to love you even as Christ loves me. I will forgive you daily, even as He forgives me. I will protect you, ever striving to lead our family as God has commanded me. I will honor you as He has commanded me. I will forsake all others to be yours only, as is the heart of God. I will be your shoulder to cry on, and don't worry, I don't mind wet shoulders. I will never leave you as long as we both shall live, even as Christ will never forsake us. And though the day may come when I fall and I fail to be all that Christ has commanded me to be, I promise you this: I will keep pressing forward toward the mark for the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. And one day when He's done with me, He will complete my vow and make me all that you ever deserve. I love you.
Jabez, my love, in the presence of God, our family and friends, I, Gazel Sudoro, take you, Jabez Daniel Wells, to be my lawfully wedded husband. Babe, you are an answer to all my prayers. You always ask me, what do you see in me that you choose me? I've answered that before, but today I will remind you. I see a man that honors and loves God. You said it before we started dating, that you want to honor God and He will be your priority. So I was so glad when you said that, and I have been praying to have a relationship that God will be the center. I see a man that cherishes his family. You have showed how you love your family and have seen how you treat your parents especially, and how you love your nephews and nieces and your siblings. And that makes my heart warm, and I know that you will love our family in the future more. I see a man that looks after the people around him first before himself. I see a man who loves and genuinely cares about his friends. You said, when you said that Alex has a special place in your heart, that means to me that you treasure your friends the same way that you will treasure me for our lifetime. And of course, you are tall. I specifically prayed for that. You have taught me how to be practical with things like no more Jordan shoes. I love how you appreciate little things about me. Our love story begins with good friendship, then our dating journey, and now becoming husband and wife. My love, I will spend the rest of my life thanking God for loving me so much to send me his very best. I promise to be the helper God intended me to be. I will honor you and submit to you. I will follow you as we follow Christ together. I will cover our home with prayers. I will work alongside with you, our home, and in the ministry God will have for us. I will love you and be faithful to you alone. From this day forward, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, until God calls us home. I love you.
Jabez, do you take Gazel to be your wife, to live together according to God's appointment in the holy relationship of marriage? Do you commit to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, forsaking all others, keeping only unto her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Gazel, do you take Jabez to be your husband, to live together according to God's appointment in the holy relationship of marriage? Do you commit to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, forsaking all others, keeping only unto him until death do you part?
I do.
Jabez, please repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
Commitment and faithfulness to you.
Commitment and faithfulness to you.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Gazel, please repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
Commitment and faithfulness to you.
Commitment and faithfulness to you.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Let's pray. Fathers, we have witnessed the commitment Jabez and Gazel have made to holy matrimony. Please bring them together for your glory. May you guide them each day and lead them to the life you have for them. May their hearts be knit, and may your hand of blessing be upon them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Right here and now begins the journey of my dreams on to forever, hand in hand with the calls to me. I have tomorrow to look forward to. For God has given me you to have and to hold, to cherish and honor, to love and call my very own, to share all I am with body, heart and soul. You are mine, I am yours, to have and to hold. Cherish and honor, to love and call my very own, to share all I am with body, heart and soul. You are mine, as I am yours, to have and to
For as much as you have consented together in marriage and have pledged your faithfulness to each other before God and these witnesses, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ and according to the laws of the state of Queensland, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Jabez, you may now kiss your bride. And ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, may I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Wells.
Thank you.